opportunities and threats related to a business and its need. The objective of this course is to provide a framework to understand it in relation to the entrepreneurship to scan internal and external environment. Let's first understand the meaning of SWOT analysis. It is a basic tool which is a fundamental requirement for the marketer, entrepreneur and business person. We adopt this analysis in marketing management and other business applications. SWOT analysis refers to environmental factor, where internal factor to the firm usually can be classified into strength or weaknesses, and those external to the firm can be classified as opportunities or threats. It involves specifying the objective of the business venture or project and identifying the internal and external factors that are favorable and unfavorable to achieve the objectives. A SWOT analysis can be carried out for the product, place, industry or person. Identification of SWOT is important because they can inform step in planning to achieve the objective. Firstly, the decision maker should consider whether the objective is attainable or not. If the objective is not attainable, a different objective must be selected and the process is repeated. The degree to which the internal environment of the firm matches with the external environment is expressed by the concept of strategic fit. Strength refers to the characteristic of the business or project that gives it an advantage over others. Weaknesses refers to the characteristic that places the business or project at the disadvantage relative to others. Opportunities are elements that project could exploit to its advantage, and threats are elements in the environment that could cause trouble for the business or project. The SWOT analysis provides information that is helpful in matching the firm's resources and capabilities to the competitive environment in which it operates. SWOT analysis aims to identify the key internal and external factors seen as important in achieving an objective. SWOT analysis groups key pieces of information into two main categories, internal and external factors. Now look at the framework of SWOT analysis. Users of SWOT analysis need to ask and answer questions that generates meaningful information for each category to make the analysis useful and find their competitive advantage. Analysis may view the internal factor as strength or as weaknesses depending upon their effect on the organization objective. What may represent strength with respect to one objective may be weakness for the other objective. The factor may include all four P's as well as personal, financial, manufacturing capabilities and so on. The external factors may include microeconomics, matters, technological changes, legislation and socio-culture changes, as well as changes in the marketplace or in competitive position. The results are often presented in the form of a matrix. Now, let's study these internal and external factors in detail. A firm's strength are its resources and capabilities that can be used for developing a competitive advantages. Example of strength are strong brand name, popularity, good reputation in market. Now let's see the weaknesses, where it may be shortage of consultant at operating level rather than the partner level, and unable to deal with the multidisciplinary assignment because of size or lack of ability. A weakness may be flip side of a strength. If a firm has a large amount of manufacturing capacity, while this capacity may be considered as a strength that competitors do not share, it also may be considered as a weakness if the large investment in marketing capacity prevents the firm from reacting quickly to the changes in the strategic environment. Opportunities are external attractive factor that represent reason your business is likely to prosper. Some related questions are: what opportunities exist in your market or the environment that you can benefit from? Is the perception of your business positive? Is the opportunity ongoing or is just a window for it? In other words, how critical is your timing? Threats include external factors beyond your control that could place your strategy or the business itself at a risk. You have no control over these, but you may benefit by having plans to address them if they could occur. Some examples of the threats are shifting in the customer taste away from the firm's product, emergence of substitute product, new regulation, and increased trade barriers. The concept of determining the strength, weakness, threats, and opportunities is the fundamental idea behind the SWOT model. To present the model in a more understandable way, scholars has come up and so-called SWOT matrix. SWOT matrix is the only graphical representation of SWOT framework. Tao's analysis is very similar to the SWOT method. Tao's, that is TOWS, simply looks at the negative factor first in order to turn them into the positive factor. You can see the Tao matrix on your screen, where internal and external factors are categorized in different categories. Let's understand these categories, which comes under SWOT and Tao's analysis. SO strategies pursue opportunities that fit well with the company's strength. WO strategies overcome the weaknesses to pursue opportunities. ST strategies identify ways that the firm can use its strength to reduce external threats. WO strategies make a defensive plan to prevent the firm's weakness. There are some simple rules that you can create a SWOT matrix in SWOT analysis. Be realistic. Make sure you assess your situation objectively. It is better to be pessimistic about weaknesses and threats and lighter about strength and opportunities. Next, today versus future. When you're doing the SWOT analysis, distinguish between today's state of your business and your expectation for the future. Mixing your expectation with the current state will result in skewed outcome. Also, keep your SWOT matrix short and simple. Avoid complexity and over-analysis. If you want to include many points to each quadrant of the SWOT matrix, it is a good idea to weight them. If a new firm is coming into the market, then this creates a threat because it can take away your current customers. Someone else might see the same company as opportunity because that company might have innovative ideas which your business can explore. And your business might even benefit from the possible takeover of your new competitor. Thank you.